Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. Welcome to a new video of chapter 5, which is 5.3 solid. In this video, we're going to explain the fixed shape of a solid, apply the kinetic concept to explain freezing, melting, sublimation and deposition, and state the types of crystalline solid with example of metal, ionic, molecular covalent and giant covalent. Okay, so for our solid, we know that the particles are arranged closely together. So contohnya kalau kita compare kan, solid liquid dengan gas, it is arranged closely and it has definite shape and volume. Okay, and then it actually has strong forces between the particles. So when the attractive forces, the intermolecular forces to increase ataupun very strong, sebab itulah are able to arrange closely and rigidly. Okay. And it has high densities and incompressible. We cannot reduce it in size lah. Kalau compare dengan liquid dengan gas, kita boleh. But solid, it cannot be compressed. Okay. So next, what we're going to look at is actually the process of solid. So, for the solid itself, kita adanya proses freezing. Okay, freezing ni macam kita nak apa ni? Freezekan air kita untuk jadi ice. So, what happened for the freezing, it occur when the temperature is lowered ataupun when temperature decrease. Okay, what would happen is that the kinetic energy decrease. So, the particle move slowly, sangat slow. Lepas tu lagi rapat kan? And it cannot overcome the intermolecular forces. So, maknanya dia dah memang, kalau compare dengan gas, liquid ni memang ada intermolecular force pun. Tapi bila kinetic energy decrease, lagilah dia move slowly, lagilah attractive forces between the gas molecule tu, lagilah strong. So, when it is strong, it is able to hold the particle together in a fixed and orderly arrangement. Okay, that is for freezing liquid to solid. Okay, kalau solid to liquid. So, next is actually the melting. Contohnya kalau kita nak cairkan aiskrim kita, walaupun kenalah cairkan sikit kan nak makan. Okay, so how does melting occur? It actually when the temperature increase. Okay, when temperature increase, what will happen? The kinetic energy increase. Okay, so the particles move faster. Okay, sebab kinetic energy increase kan, so the particles move faster and able to overcome IMF. Can overcome the intermolecular forces. So dia dah move faster kan? So bila dia dah boleh escape IMF tu, dia bolehlah jadi kita punya liquid where it able to move freely. So that is actually the process of freezing and melting where we concerning ourselves for solid dengan liquid. Between yang solid dengan liquid ni lah. Okay, next we're going to look at for the case kalau solid to gas. Okay, so the process is deposition where gas change to solid. So it is a substance changes directly from gas to solid without passing through liquid phase. Okay, selalunya kan kita membelajar dia akan jadi solid, solid jadi liquid, liquid jadi gas kan. Tapi deposition ni from solid, from gas to solid. Okay. So example of deposition ni adalah formation of froth. Our water vapor ni will change straight away to solid. Sebab tu lah. Okay. So again, deposition ni is actually process from gas to solid. For example, the formation of froth lah. Contohnya, selalunya kat Malaysia ni tak ada lah. Okay, so what happen is that, contohnya it's very cold. What happen is that our water vapor tu, water vapor tu it won't change into liquid. Dia tak akan jadi air, tapi dia akan terus jadi solid, which is our froth ni lah. Okay, so next is actually sublimation. Sublimation is substance changes directly from solid to gas. So maknanya kalau dari sini kat sini kan, ni kat sini, dia jadi the other way round. So from solid to gas. Okay, so for example ni ubat gegat. Tak tahulah kamu tahu ubat gegat ke tak kan. Tapi yang ni kalau letak yang warna putih ni bukan mentos tau. Yang putih yang kamu letak kat rumah tu. Ataupun yang inilah kita punya apa ni? Glade tu ataupun MB Pure. So what happen is that This is an example of sublimation. Contohnya, kalau kamu letak je kat bilik kamu, kalau Miss letak kat office sebab tak nak tikus, okay. Kalau kamu letak sahaja, okay, as time goes by, kamu akan nampak this ubat gegat ni makin lama dah makin kecil. Okay, why? Because from solid ni, dia akan change to gas. So, sebab itulah, apa ni? So, this is actually example of sublimation. Sama juga, kalau contohnya kamu letak dekat bilik, contohnya bila kamu buka kan, kamu akan buka lah penutup dia ni. Okay, kalau kamu buka lama-lama dah sebulan ke, kamu akan nampak liquid solid ni makin lama makin kecil. So, what happen is that sublimation occur where the solid ni akan change to gas. Sebab tu lah nanti masuk bilik jadi bau wangi. Kalau yang ni, adalah bau ubat gegat dia tu. Tapi, yelah. Okay, kalau kau nak letak ubat gegat kan, nak hala tikus. Okay. So, that is actually the example of process of solid. Okay, next kita akan tengok the type of solid. So, type of solid, there are two types of solid, which is crystalline, where the atom, ion or molecule are ordered in well-defined arrangement. It is formed when a liquid is cooled slowly, and its atom, molecule or ion occupy specific position. So, example dia ni lah crystalline SiO2. Our quartz itself. Ataupun kita punya diamond ni lah. Diamond ni is actually example of crystalline solid. Tapi kalau amorphous pula, it is actually when the solid, our particle have no orderly structure and it is formed when the liquid is cooled rapidly. Okay, kalau kita compare kan crystalline yang ini dengan amorphous SiO2 which is our glass. So you can see yang ini in orderly manner. It has a well-ordered arrangement lah. Kalau compare kan dengan glass kita. Sama lah juga dengan diamond kita ni kan. Sebenarnya kalau kita zoom lagi. Diamond ni is well ordered and have orderly structure. Whereas amorphous diamond ni have no orderly structure. Okay, so that is actually the type of solid. Next, we're going to look at example of crystalline solid. Yang ni kita include apa yang kita dah belajar dalam chapter 4. Okay, so first type of crystalline solid is ionic solid. Example dia NaCl. Apa lagi kita punya example. Boleh jadi MgCl2. Boleh macam-macam lah. Tapi make sure it is ionic. Okay. So, what is the intermolecular forces ataupun bonding? Okay. Nama dia is actually ionic bond. Okay. So, it is actually ionic bond ni kita kena explain what is ionic bond. Ionic bond is actually cation and anion held by strong electrostatic force. Or sometimes it is also called as electrovalent bond lah. Okay, so that's the first one. Okay, the second one is metallic solid. So the all metallic element yang kita dah belajar in 4.5 is actually element kita dekat group 1, group 2, group 13. And sebenarnya transition element pun transition element, but transition metal pun is considered as metallic element. Transition metal. Betul tak ni? Transition metal. Okay, so what is actually the intermolecular forces ataupun bonding? It is actually metallic bond. So, kita tulis sini. Okay. It is attraction between positively charged metal ion. Charge metal ion surrounded by sea of electron. Okay, macam ni lah. Kita punya electron sea model. Okay, next example is actually molecular covalent solid. So, this is covalent kita lah. So, example dia kita punya O2, H2O, I2, ammonia, carbon dioxide. Okay, so what is actually for this, apa ni? Molecular covalent solid, it is held by our covalent bond. Okay. Where the molecule forms lattice. Lattice ni maknanya arrangement dia lah. Arrangement, a lattice arrangement by weak van der Waals forces. Yang ni pun ada soalan pasir minta explain juga. Macam bagi tahulah explain the type of crystalline solid. Last but not least is giant covalent solid for the diamond. Okay, so giant covalent solid, example dia diamond ataupun graphite kita lah, SiO2. Okay, so what is actually the force? Masih lagi covalent bond, it is still a covalent bond. Tapi dia ada extra sikit. Covalent bond. It is a non-metal held together by covalent bond to form a giant structure. Giant gitu. Giant structure. So, structure dia kira besar kan? Okay. So, itulah nama dia. Giant covalent solid. Kalau yang ni molecular covalent sahaja. Dua-dua masih lagi covalent bond. Tapi kalau giant ni, kita kena explain lah. Held together by covalent bond to form giant structure. Okay. So, that's it for our solid. Memang untuk solid ni ada satu video ni sahaja. Okay.